to the entertainment segment. My name is Miss G. So the beautiful video you've seen on screen is that of Yvonne Tewia. Yvonne Tewia is an accomplished musician back there in the United Kingdom. That's where she's based, but she's Ghanaian. And of course, you heard her speech, so definitely you know that she's Ghanaian. But she has too many things going on. You know, she has a huge profile. If I decide to read it to you, we might end up closing. So I'm going to have her introduce to you a lot of the things, including the fact that there's a challenge that you would have to win some prize for.
Yes,
can I partake in that challenge?
Of course.
Okay,
please,
so I want to win. I want to win the money. You know, that's enough money to give up. I think it's a, how much is that? £200.
£200.
Hey, Charlie, times six, and I he's seven. Crap.
8.2.
8.2.
Yes.
1,600 plus. Hey, I want. I'm going to contest. Great
please
to have you here.
Great to have you. Very good morning to you and your viewers as well. Mm-hmm. I'm so humbled to be here. God bless you for the opportunity.
Bless you too. So tell us about gospel, you know, in the diaspora. I always want to hear things like that because here is Ghana. You know, you have free space media. You know, it doesn't seem to be the same outside of Ghana. Tell me how you're managing gospel in the diaspora.
So it's not the same, but it's quite a privilege if you ever find yourself out there, because over here, from how we were raised, naturally, you get inculcated into it. But then it's quite a different environment. People believe in signs and quite numerous belief systems. Mm. Yeah, so it's quite challenging. But when it's a calling, he paves the way and the ear must hear you. Mm-hmm. And that is what we are riding on. By the grace of God, he's putting us in certain places and positions for us to be able to, have the attention of a few people.
She works with the American or the British Armed Forces.
I thought we were hiding.
We're not hiding that. You know, it's such a privilege, you know, for me to be sitting here with you. And she's in the HR department.
Yeah, HR specialist.
You're an HR specialist.
Yes.
Charlie, manya ejima kreye you. But it's beautiful to know that, you know, you're a professional and then you're doing music as well. And you find yourself in a very delicate space.
Very, very delicate. Mm. Yeah, and quite sensitive. Mm. But the good news is within my organization, which is one of the most powerful organizations in the world, mm-hmm. we also have the chaplaincy department, which a lot of people do not pay attention to, because when you mention military, it's always like, ooh, there we go again. But then as some HR specialist, someone's job as an officer, it's a pastor, a padre, if you would term it. Mm. And these people are with us and before and all proud to any deployment. They lead us to Christ. Mm. So it's quite imperative, and they understand what you're doing. It must be in truth and in spirit. This is what I say, because they know and they have their discernment that works. If you're doing it and believing what you're doing, they will support you. And that is one thing I'm fortunate to have.
Great. Yeah. Really fortunate to have.
Yeah.
How are you able to penetrate, you know, even your office, you know, with the kind of music that you do? Do they get to listen? Do you get to play to them? How do you do that?
It's a curiosity I attach. I don't do the basic and the norm that everyone is used to. Mm. I believe the mansions are beautiful. We love to shoot videos in the mansions. But then what do we do in our videos to make it quite exceptional, to catch the attention of others? So if you watch the video you just played, Bazooka, it took us quite a long time to come up with the concept and what we wanted, because it's a Zulian language and Bazooka is Supreme God. So we wanted something that depicted the root of South Africa. That's why you see the dancers dressed in that costume. It was particularly picked, intentionally picked.
Wow.
And that mixed them work. What's that?
Mm-hmm.
Where did they get that dress from? Mm. And from there, we move on.
Mm.
So then we talk about
you've captured
that.
Them.
Yes. So then, what does Bazooka mean? Supreme God. Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
So then we get it on.
Mm.
Yeah. So gradually, that's how it's been. Mm. Yeah. And we have Sheeta coming up. It will be, by the grace of God, to be shot in Ghana.
Wow.
Expect rich Ghanaian culture, pure culture.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Why, like you're saying, very particular about what goes into the video and to capture these folks.
Mm-hmm.
Are they also not some inhibitions, you know, when you're putting together these things? Because, you know, there's a way Christendom looks at certain things and are very particular about the output of anybody who says they're doing gospel. Aren't there any inhibitions?
You're doing gospel, but you're doing it for the world. You're not doing it for yourself. You're doing it for others to partake and tap into what God has deposited in you. So it is not just about, trust me, if you do about me, I should do videos. I'll just put my CD on in my room, pray with my family, my husband and my kids, and here we moved on. But where the space I find myself, the dominancy is not Ghanaian. We have people all over the place in this environment. And so whatever you're doing to capture the attention of these ones must be particularly, you have to pay attention to these things. We are spreading the kingdom work. We're doing what Christ wants us to do. We're just doing a little bit more to get their attention. So it's the same thing we're doing. And even in Ghana, a lot of things seem to be the same way and the norm. But sometimes, let's represent him as the citizens that we are in the kingdom.
When you say it looks like the norm or the things are repetitive, what does it mean? What would you rather see, you know, in Ghana? Because you've been exposed more than a lot of them. What would you want to see?
So I want to see more of Ghana. Not just the beautiful clothes. It's beautiful. I want to see them. But we've just returned from Kumasi, the Ashanti region, and they are great places that we visited. Wow. A lot of people don't know of these great traditions. Seeing the sword and the history. I know the story because of education, but then I haven't really seen it. So there are some things like my son Konkra. If I shot Konkra in Ghana, trust me, I'll be shooting in Kumasi.
Oh, wow.
Yes, you see, there are some basic things that I will want to see. And in the video, we have vast land, the greens, show this beauty side to people. And because the basic norm, I believe a lot of people are used to, we're used to the flash and then the good world and then all of that. But there's some authenticity that needs to be seen that I don't think that people get opportunity to see.
Now, let's talk about Ghana Music Awards UK, where you have two nominations.
Yeah,
let's quickly talk about that. I know the event is happening in October. How optimistic are you?
Anyway, that is why, so God paved the way for you to be there, but when you get it, you gotta put in the work. And that's one of the reasons why I'm here, putting in the work, announcing to the world, please vote. So UK-based gospel artist of the year we are on, and the song that got nominated was Bizuka.
Oh, wow.
Now, ask me why again.
Tell me.
The answer, you have the answer already. I just answered it.
Okay. Because of the way you shot
the difference is so clear, because Bizuka has already won an international award of the last year it won the best video, international video of the year, and UK Women Worship International Music Award.
Wow.
Exactly. So that tells me a lot, and that is where I intend to follow the journey when it comes to productions and things like that. Also the song of the year, UK based song of the year, we are also on it, looking forward to that. I mean, whoever is on it is a great musician, a great gospel artist that God is pretty. Whoever wins, I thank God for the person's life. I believe you put in the work.
Let's vote for her. I am hoping that she picks both awards, you know.
I'm humbled. Thank you.
Let's also talk about your philanthropy. It's written, when the profile was sent to me, that was in capital letters, you know, in order to be emphasized that, and I want to say that you have the Yvonne Asamoah-Tawiya Ministry, so it's called Yacht Ministry. And she's donated to several organizations, but she's donated to the UK Cerebral Palsy
Action Cerebral Palsy.
Yeah, and then also the Eye of the Lord Orphanage here in Ghana. So you're not doing, you know, this philanthropy work just out there, but you're concentrating here as well. Yeah. Tell me why that's also part of your ministry.
So I'm so passionate about this because this is a part of what people don't know. My second child is a special child.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
And congratulations to you. Enough respect to anybody with a special child.
I'm humble. Thank you. And the experience that we've had in October, on the 30th of October, my child is turning 4 years old, and it's been a miracle. If I had to tell you how it all happened, I'm not sure we have enough time to do this, but at the end of the day, he's gotten the assistance that he needs because of the state we live in, the support, the equipment that he needs, and so he's in mainstream education like every other child and given the same opportunity.
Wow.
And specialist care as well, which I believe a lot of NGOs do not have access to. Hence the need for me to step in.
Okay.
Because I know what it is and what these equipment can cost. Some of them cost like £5,000. How many families can afford these ones? That's even true. When you live in the United Kingdom, no. And we have the Action Cerebral Palsy, which is my son's diagnosis. So if there's anything that could struck me. Mm-hmm. That is a place I want to go. So any home with a disability, eventually you've won me. Oh. It just has to be legitimate. And by the grace of God, last year we got the Asheville community supporting the cause, and a group in UK called Precious Jewels. They founded it.
Wow.
Yeah. And so please, if you're an NGO out there, next year we're looking forward to picking a legitimate home. Mm-hmm. And you have a disability in your home, kindly DM us, contact us. We will come visit you. The team in Ghana will come and visit you. And legitimately, if we find you verified, registered and verified, we will see what we can do. We will liaise with people out there. And what he can do, I believe God will lead them.
You want to put a DM that, what account should they DM out
Yeah, so
there?
Minister Yvonne on Instagram. Mm. Yeah, it's so snap. Also on Facebook, Yvonne Samuateria. Mm. That person, all you need to do is to wave your hand. Hello, I'm like, hi, I'm here.
And also, quickly before you go, let's talk about the Shida Challenge. £200.
Yes. Yeah.
1,600 plus Ghana cedis. Let's talk about that.
Thank you. So with Bazooka, it was £150.
Oh.
And it was sponsored by a radio station in Ghana. I wouldn't mention the name on this platform.
Thank you very
much. Yeah, but a media station sponsored that. And this time, once again, you see, when Christ is involved, you never lose a mark.
Mm.
When you call the show, he brings people on board to also support the cause. So all you need to do is to video yourself dancing to Shida.
Mm.
Post it on your social media platform. Now you determine the price. If you're going to win, it's up to you. Share, get the highest views. And that's what we need. So the reason why you are targeting me is just so at the end of August, we can go and check who had the highest views. And if you did, £200 straight up to you.
Hey, so the video is not out yet, but
I'll be working on the video.
So you just have to join the challenge. Dance challenge for Shida. We can find it where?
All the digital platforms, on YouTube, the audio slide is on YouTube. So all the digital stores, please, Spotify, Amazon, iTunes, everywhere. Or just type Yata Ministries.
Want to leave your social media handles as well.
Yes.
I know you did that earlier, but you want to reiterate it so that those who didn't get it.
Thank you. So Minister Yvonne on Instagram, Yvonne Asamoateria, Facebook, and across board, Yvonne Asamoateria, with the exception of Thriller, Yvonne Asamoati.
Okay. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you, Ms. B. You're so beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Okay. So I want to also say a special thanks to the organizers of the Western Music Awards. Over the weekend, I spent time in Takoradi. Thanks to Team Connect, that's our station in the Western region as well. Thank you so much for being great hosts, and congratulations to all the winners of the Western Music Awards. This September, join the GMB 2020 finalist, Anana AK of Talented Kids Season 11. He's the winner. And of course, the ace broadcaster, Giovanni Kayla, my colleague here, as they embark on an all-exciting and memorable six-day trip to Dubai, per person on double occupancies just for 7,485 CDs. Now you can contact Global Wings Travel and Tour Limited, the agency responsible for the trip, on 054-100-4130 or 0553-688-398 or visit the offices inside the UDS Guest House, Cantonment, Accra, or inside the Seniors Clubhouse First Floor UCC Campus to facilitate all your travel arrangements and flight booking. You don't want to miss the fun. Well, just Giovanni, there's definitely fun. Thank you so much. Today is our director's birthday. You were told to play a song for yourself, Michael. Congratulations to you, Michael. Happy birthday to you. I'm sure that Bella will take you for lunch. That'll be it for today's edition of TV3 New Day. We're back tomorrow with some more right here. Thank you so much once again,
Thank you so much for joining us.
Trust
me, it's my birthday today.
Oh, it's your birthday as well?
Yes.
Oh, happy birthday to Yvonne.
Thank you.
Happy birthday and God bless you.
God bless you too.
Win the awards, you know.
Humble. I can't wait to see you in the UK.
Hopefully,
yes.
I'll show up. All
Please
right,
do.
So see you tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of our programming.